Welcome to Diamond Group of Institutions, NEET and KSET online classes. So today we are going to discuss previous questions in thermodynamics chapter. So see the first question. A Carnot engine has an efficiency of 1/6. Efficiency they given 1/6. And when the temperature of the sink is reduced by 62 degrees centigrade. Okay, if the sink temperature reduced by 62 degrees centigrade, its efficiency is doubled. Efficiency is become double. The temperature of the source and the sink are respectively. We have to find the source and sink temperatures. Okay. See now, in the Carnot engine, this temperature values we will get in the absolute temperatures. That means in terms of the Kelvin we will get. Okay. So initially the given temperature, efficiency of the Carnot engine is 1/6 of the given. Okay, so we know the efficiency formula for the Carnot engine. Neta equal to the 1 minus T2 by T1. Neta is the efficiency of the Carnot engine. T2 is the temperature of the source and T2 is the temperature of the sink and T1 is the temperature of the source. Okay, so initially the given efficiency of the Carnot engine is 1/6. So first case mein efficiency is 1/6. Equal to 1 minus T2 by T1. So send T2 by T1 this side and 1/6 send this side. So T2 by T1 equal to 1 minus 1/6. 1 minus 1/6 is nothing but the 5/6. So this value keep it. And the next case may what the given means, temperature of the sink is reduced by the 62 degrees. So next case may sink ka temperature reduced by the 62 degrees centigrade and efficiency become double. Initially how much is there? 1/6. Now become double means 2 into 1/6, 2/6. Okay na? So if the temperature of the sink reduced by 62 degrees centigrade, efficiency will become double. So initially it is a 1/6. So now the efficiency is double to the initial. So 2 into 1/6, 2/6. Now substitute these values in the formula. Neta equal to the 1 minus T2 by C1. Neta equal to 1 minus T2 dash by T1. Neta value is now 2/6. Become the double 1 minus T2 dash. The sink ka temperature reduced by the 62 degree centigrade. So T2 minus 62 by T1. Initially sink temperature is T2. Now 62 degree centigrade reduced. That's why T2 minus 62 I am writing here. So now I substituted here. T2 minus 62 by T1 I am sending to the left side, T2/6 sending to the right side, then T2 minus 62 by T1 equal to 1 minus 2/6 is nothing but 4/6. Now here I am writing individually T2 by T1 minus 62 by T1 equal to 4/6. T2 by T1 value from this, T2 by T1 equal to how much? 5/6. So now 5/6 minus 62 by T1 equal to 4/6. Now send this minus 62 by T1 this side, 4/6 to that side. So 62 by T1 equal to 4/6 and this side. 5/6 minus 4/6. Denominator same as 6. 5 minus 4, 1. 1/6. Now T1 value, cross multiplication. 62 into 6, 372 kelvins. I said already T1, T2, temperatures of source and sink are absolute temperatures in terms of the kelvins. So T1 temperature is 372 kelvin. If we get the T1, T2, we can find it very easily. The relationship between the T2 and T1 is T2 by T1 equal to 5/6. From that, T2 equal to the 5/6 into T1 value is 372, we will get the T2 value is 310 kelvins. So T1 is the 372 kelvin and T2 is the 310 kelvins. But options are in terms of the degree centigrade. So now convert this kelvin temperatures into the degree centigrade. Now T1 equal to 372, now 372 minus 273, then we will get 99 degree centigrade. T2 value is 310 minus 273, 37 degree centigrade. So the option is 37 degree centigrade, 99. They are asking the source and the sink are respectively. Okay na? Source and sink temperatures, source temperature is how much? Source T1 equal to 99 degree centigrade. Sorry, not B option. B option is the right answer. First they are asking source and the next they are asking the sink. Source is 99, source T1 is the source, it is equal to the 99, T2 is the sink, sinker temperature is 37. Okay, now don't get confusion. Here we solve the total problem, we got 99 and 37. If you see the option D also, there 99 and 37, but here the question is source and sink are respectively. First we have to get source temperature, next sink temperature. Source temperature is 99, sink temperature is 37. 99, 37. See the options carefully. Okay. So now see the next question. When heat Q is supplied to adiabatic gas of rigid molecules, At constant volume, its temperature increases by del T. The heat required to produce the same change in temperature at constant pressure is. So, heat supplied to a adiabatic gas. Okay, now. So, heat supplied to a adiabatic, not to a diatomic gas. Heat supplied to a diatomic gas. Okay, now. Heat supplied to a diatomic gas at constant value. The formula is Q equal to the NCV del T. Okay, now. Heat supplied to a diatomic gas at heat supplied to a gas at constant volume formula is Q equal to NCV dT. At same change in temperature, heat supplied to the gas at constant pressure formula is Q dash equal to the NCP del T. Okay, now. So, either ka temperature difference and here ka temperature difference is same, but whatever the temperature difference is, here heat required is Q, here heat required is Q dash. Okay, now. Why? At constant volume, at constant pressure. Once you see the theory also, now see here, Q dash by Q equal to, that means how much temperature, how much heat required for the same change in the temperature at constant pressure, we have to find in terms of the Q. Okay, now. So, now Q dash by Q equal to the NCP del theta by NCV del T. Del T del T will be cancelled, NN will be cancelled, Cp by Cv. So, Cp by Cv equal to gamma, already we know, adiabatic constant. So, now Q dash equal to the Q into gamma we will get, and they given here diatomic gas. For diatomic gas, gamma value is the 7/5. So 7/5. So Q dash equal to 7/5 Q. So how much amount of heat required for the gas at a constant pressure to bring the same change in the temperature is 7/5 Q. Okay, now the answer 7/5 Q is the right answer. D option is the right answer. Remember the problems. Okay. Okay, see the next question. Following figure shows two processes A and B for a gas. Okay, two processes they given. If del QA and del QB are the amount of heat absorbed by the system in two cases, okay, amount of heat absorbed, and del UA and del UB are the changes in the internal energies respectively, then they given some relationships. So, see now here. P, pressure on the y-axis, volume on the x-axis. Now, one process is from here to here A process, from here to here B process. Okay, na? So, in the option, they given the relationship between the heat energies and internal energies. Okay, so, from the first law of thermodynamics, we know that the heat supplied or absorbed by the system is equal to the heat supplied to the system equal to the work done plus internal energy. Okay, change in the internal energy. We have this formula. Okay, this is the formula. So now here, internal energy is independent of the path. That means it is only depend on the initial and final points of the path only. So A process is in this way and B process is in this way, but A and B process both have the same initial point and the same final point. So internal energy is the independent of path. So okay, na? So it is not depending on the path. For the A process and B process, both have the same initial and same final points. So both have the same internal energies. Same internal energy, del UA equal to the del UB. And the next one, next to the relationship given in terms of the heat energies. Okay, na? Heat absorbed by the system. Na? So, see now, from this formula, del Q equal to W plus del U. So, both the process del U is same. That means, the Q heat absorbed by the system is depending on the work done. Okay, depending on the work done now. So, see now, A process. This is the PV graph. So, per PV graph, area under the graph will give the work done. So, A ka work done is this much. Okay. B ka work done is this much area only. So, the area covered by the A curve is more than the area covered by the B curve. So, area is more means work done is more. So, work done for the A process is more than the work done by the B process. Okay. If work done is more for the A process, heat absorbed by the A process is more, del QA is more than the heat absorbed by the B process. okay na, so work done for the A process is more than the work done for the B process na, so then heat absorbed by the A process is more than the heat absorbed by the B process. Okay, first internal energies we have to find. Internal energy is the path independent, it is not depending on the path. So A process, B process ka initial and final point same, so internal energies are same, and we have to compare the work done. Which has the more work, that absorb the more heat. So work done for the A is more, so it will absorb the more heat. So from this option UA equal to UB and QA is, so C option is the right answer. In this way solve the problem, okay na. And next come to see the next question. For the given cyclic process CAB, okay, CAB cyclic process as shown for a gas, the work done is, okay na, so work done we have to find. So now P on y axis they are taking the pressure and x axis they are taking the volume. If they give the pressure and volume graph, then we can find it very easily. Work done, work done is nothing but the area under that graph curve will give the work done. Okay, see now this process is the cyclic process. Okay, so and next cyclic process may internal energy equal to the zero, remember that one. Next in this cyclic process, this is the anti-clockwise process or clockwise process, we have to decide first. CAB, this is the clockwise process. So if it is clockwise, then work done equal to the positive. If it is anti-clockwise, okay na, if it is anti-clockwise, okay, work done equal to the negative. Now here it is in the clockwise direction only, so if process is the clockwise process, so work done equal to the positive. Work done is nothing but the area under the graph or area under the area enclosed by the curve. Okay, so work done equal to the, this is the shape of triangle shape on either right angle triangle like this. So now half into base into height, half into base means this one, okay, so final place is here 5 and initial is here 1, so 5 minus 1, okay, 5 minus 1, okay. Next to height, this one, so final is here 1 and this one is the 6, okay na? So from here to here height is 6 minus 1, okay, so then half into 5 minus 1 is the 4, 6 minus 1 is the 5, we will get 2 1 so 2 2 5 into 2 10 joules. Okay, work done equal to the 10 joules here. Okay, next one more thing you have to remember, volume they given in terms of the meter cube, pressure they given the pascals, so that's why directly I will get the work done equal to the 10 joules. Sometimes what they will give, they give the pascals in terms of the other values, okay na, and meter cube in place of meter cube they may give the millimeter cube or 10 power 6 meter cube or like this they will give, then here powers will be changed, okay na, but here direct given pressure in the pascals and volume in the meter cube, so directly substituting. Instead of the pascal and meter cube, if they give the multiplies, okay, either use the multiplies also, okay na, remember this, okay na, these two questions are very important questions. The next question, a rigid diatomic ideal gas undergoes an adiabatic process at room temperature. The relation between temperature and volume for this process is T V power X equal to the constant, then X is the given, T into V power X equal to the constant they given in the question. And the next one more thing they mention, undergoes a diatomic adiabatic process, undergoes a adiabatic process. In the adiabatic process, okay na, so adiabatic process, so in the adiabatic process the relationship between the temperature and volume, so T into V power gamma minus 1 equal to the constant. Actually in adiabatic process we have the P into V power gamma equal to the constant, so based on this relationship we can find the relationship between the volume and temperature and pressure and temperature also. So now according to this question they given the relationship temperature and volume power X equal to constant, so I am going to write the relationship between the temperature and volume in the adiabatic process. So in the adiabatic process the relationship T into V power gamma minus 1 equal to constant, gamma is the adiabatic constant, okay. So and one more thing they mention here, diatomic gas, okay na, this is the nothing but the diatomic gas. One thing remember, gamma value for the diatomic we can write it as directly 7/5, but here to remember the formula I am writing here. So for diatomic gas, degree of freedom equal to the 5, monatomic 3 and triatomic 7, Okay, so gamma equal to the, for triatomic remember linear, non-linear, there remember that case also. In the first video I explained that one, watch that one. So gamma equal to the 1 plus 2 by f, remember this formula. This is the relationship between the adiabatic constant and the degree of freedom. Okay, so gamma equal to 1 plus 2 by f. For diatomic gas, degree of freedom is a 5, and gamma equal to, we will get 7 by 5. Directly also we can write diatomic gas gamma value is 7 by 5 for monatomic, triatomic, okay, na? So for monatomic 5 by 3, for triatomic 9 by 7, we have the values, okay, remember. So now, here in the diatomic T into V power gamma minus 1, but in the question they given T into V power X. So now equate the powers, gamma minus 1 equal to the X. Now gamma minus 1 equal to the X, they are asking the X value. Gamma value we found that is equal to the 7 by 5. So 7 by 5 minus 1 equal to X, now X equal to the 2 by 5. So what is the value of the X? X equal to the 2 by 5, option A is the right answer. Like this we have to solve the problem. So here this formula, remember the relationship between the adiabatic constant and degree of freedom, okay, na? And for diatomic gases, remember the degree of freedom and adiabatic constant value also. And next come to see the next question. Half mole of an ideal monoatomic gas is heated at a constant pressure, okay, na? Constant pressure of 1 atmosphere. From 20 degree centigrade to 90 degree centigrade, work done by gas is close to the, okay, nearest value we have to find. So for the constant pressure, work done formula equal to the P into del V. So from the ideal gas equation, PV equal to nRT. So from this P del V equal to nR del T, we can write. That means at constant pressure, the work done formula del W equal to the nR del T or P del V, anything depending on the given data, we can use this formula. So but here change in the temperature given, that's why I'm taking this formula, okay. If they given the change in the volume, we will take this formula, okay, na? Pressure is constant, volume changes. So at constant pressure, how much work done, if volume changes, means we have to use this formula P del V. Here they given the change in the temperature, that's why nR del T formula we have to use. And the next, half mole of an ideal monatomic gas, half mole, n equal to how much? Half. And the next, change in the temperature, 90 minus 20 equal to the how much? 70 degree centigrade. If you convert this degree centigrade into the absolute temperatures, and if you find the difference, temperature difference also, you will get the same value, okay, na? In absolute temperature or degree centigrade also, you will get the temperature difference is 70 only. Why I am taking the Kelvin, means here R value they given, joule per mole, Kelvin they given, that's why I am taking the value in terms of the Kelvins, okay. But temperature difference in the degree centigrade scale and in the Kelvin scale, we will get same value. Okay, next, substitute in the formula. So del W equal to the what? nR del T. N equal to how much? Half mole, 1 by 2. R value they given already, 8.31 into del T, temperature difference is 70 Kelvin, 70. Now simplify it, almost we will get nearest value is 291 joules. Okay, the A option is the right answer. Here you have to remember the formula, work done at a constant pressure. We have the two formulas, one is P del V and one more is the nR del T. Based on the given data, we have to choose the formula. Okay, see the next question, seventh question. Three Carnot engines operates in series between each sources at a temperatures T1, each source at temperature T1, source ka temperature T1, and a heat sink at a temperature T4, sink at temperature T4. There are two other reservoirs, okay, na? There are two other reservoirs at temperatures T2 and T3 as shown in as shown with this is the given diagram, and the given that T1 is greater than, T2 is greater than, T3 is greater than T4. The three engines are equally efficient. If these three engines are equally efficient, then what is the condition they given? That means T2, T3 values we have to find. T2 value is in terms of the T1, T4, and T3 value is also in terms of the T1, T4, okay. So now here this is the first engine, Carnot engine, first engine, second engine, third engine. First engine ka source, this is the source, and this one is the sink, okay, na? Source, sink. Second engine, source, sink. Third engine, source, sink, okay. So now already for the Carnot engine efficiency formula, we know efficiency equal to 1 minus sink temperature by source temperature. For first Carnot engine ki efficiency neta 1 equal to the 1 minus sink temperature T2 source temperature T1. Sink temperature, source temperature. Sink temperature by source temperature. Come next. Second engine ki efficiency 1 minus sink temperature by source temperature. Sink temperature by source temperature. Third cornered engine efficiency is 1 minus sink temperature by source temperature. Sink temperature by source temperature. And one more thing they given. Three engines are equally efficient. Efficiency of the three engines is same. Neta 1 equal to neta 2 equal to the neta 3. Three engines have the same efficient. Now equate this one. 1 minus T2 by T1. Neta 1 equal to. And neta 2 place me 1 minus T3 by T2. And neta 3 place me 1 minus T4 by T3. Okay na? 1 will be cancelled out. Then we will get T2 by T1 equal to T3 by T2 equal to T4 by T3. This we will get. According to the option, they found the T2 and T3 in terms of the T1 and T4. Okay, T2 and T2 they are asking now. So now equate this two. T3 we have to find now, equate this two. Okay, if we equate this two, T2 into T2, T2 square equal to T1 into T3. If we equate these two, we will get T3 into T3, T3 square into T2 into T4, T2 into T4. Okay, na? So next, remember this, we have to keep some these values. And next, to get this one, what we have to do means, simply we have to do the square both sides, these two equations. I'm squaring both sides. This will become T2 square already there and squaring. So T2 power 4 equal to T1 square into T3 square. Okay. This is also square both sides. T3 power 4 equal to T2 square into T4 square. Why I'm squaring both sides means here I got the T2 value in terms of the T1, T3. But here the T2 value in terms of the T1, T4. Okay, so T3 value. Okay, T3 square value we know, but T3 value we don't know. If we square this side, we will get the T3 square value. We can substitute this value very easily. Here also, T2, T4. T3 value here, T2, T4. But actually in the option, T1, T4. So, either T2 value, T2, T4 value we don't know, but T2 square value we don't know. If we square this one, we can get substitute this value easily. That's why I squared both sides. I got now T2 power 4 equal to T1 square into T3 square. Now T2 power 4 equal to T1 square into T3 square ka value. T3 square ka value kitna? T2 into T4. Now here one T2, here T2 power 4 is there na. One will be cancelled, we will get T2 power 3 equal to T1 square into T power 4. Now T2 value in terms of the T1, T4 only. Now T2 equal to 3 send that side, it will become 1 by 3. So T1 square into T4, 1 by 3. So this T2 value completed. Now come to see the T3 side. So we squared na. So T3 power 4 equal to T2 square into T4 square. Now T3 power 4 equal to T2 square value already we know. T1 into T3. So T1 into T3 into T power square. So now either T3, here T3 power 4 is there. One T3 will be cancelled. We will get T3 power 3 equal to T1 into T power 4 whole square. Now T3 equal to power 3 send this side, it will become 1 by 3. T1 into T4 square power 1 by 3. Okay. Now T2 value in terms of the T1, T4 and T3 value in terms of the T1, T4 we got. So see the options. B option is we are getting. Okay. Na? Like this we have to solve. Okay. Na? This is the 2019 mains question. So here this Carnot engines are connected in the series combination. If Carnot engines are connected in the series combination, how to solve the problem? I explained here. Okay. Na? So remember first, the efficiency formula for the Carnot engine is 1 minus sink temperature by source temperature. Remember that one and solve, follow these steps. Okay. Next question. 1 mole of diatomic ideal gas undergoes a cyclic process ABC as shown. So here this one is a cyclic process. They given C now A to B, B to C, C to A. This is the diagram they given, cyclic process here. The process BC is adiabatic. Okay, the process BC is the adiabatic process. The temperatures at A, B and C are 400 Kelvin, 800 Kelvin, 600 Kelvin. Okay, 400, 800, 600 Kelvin respectively. Choose the correct statement. Choose the correct statement. So in options they given internal energies. So we have to find the internal energy for this graph. Okay, now this process. Okay, see now. Suppose if we consider the total process A to B, B to C, C to A. Okay, so internal energy is the path independent. It is depending on the initial and final points only. Suppose if we consider the total process, then starting point A only and finally reach to the A only. Okay, na? So initial and final points are same. So for the this process, internal energy for the ABC process, internal energy equal to the zero. Otherwise, for cyclic process, internal energy equal to the zero. Okay, for ABC process, the internal energy equal to the zero. And next come to see the next two. For AB process, what is the internal energy we have to find? For AB process, internal energy formula already we know, N into CV into del theta. So N equal to the 1 mole of the given 1 mole, N equal to the 1. CV value for the diatomic ideal, diatomic gas, na, for diatomic gas CV value is 5/2 R. Okay, na, 5/2 R into del T, change the temperature from AB process we are considering. From A to B, changing the temperature, initial 400, final 800. 800 minus 400, 400. 2 into 200, 200 into 5 R, 1000 R. Okay, the internal energy from A to B process is 1000 R. Now, in terms of the R only, they given options also. Now come to see, consider the BC process. Okay, for BC process, changing the internal energy equal to the NCV del T only, formula same, N equal to 1, del theta equal to 5 R by, sorry, CV equal to 5 R by 2, del theta, initial temperature is 800, final temperature is 600, final minus initial, 600 minus 800, minus 200, 2 into 100, 100 into 5, 5 minus 500 R. Okay, next, AB completed, BC completed, now come to see the CA, okay. For CA, changing the temperature, same formula, N into CV del theta only, N equal to 1, CV equal to 5 R by 2, del theta, changing the temperature. So initial is 600 Kelvin, final is the 400 Kelvin, final minus initial, 400 minus 600, minus 400 minus 600, minus 200. So 200, minus 500 R we are getting. So if you consider total process, this is the cyclic process, so total internal energy equal to the zero. If you consider individual, A to B is the 1000 R, B to C is the minus 500 R, C to A also minus 500 R, sum of these two also equal to the zero. So for total internal for this cyclic process equal to the zero. Now check the options. For ABC, total process zero, this is the wrong option. For CA how much? Minus 500 R, CA 700 R, wrong option. For AB process 1000 R, here they give a minus 350 R, wrong option. BC minus 500 R, minus 500 R, D option is the right answer. Like in this way we have to solve the problem. Next come to see the next question. When an ideal diatomic gas, he is heated at a constant pressure, the fraction of the heat energy supplied which increases the internal energy of the gas is. So at constant pressure, whatever the heat we are supplying, it utilizes for the two ways. One is to increase the internal energy, other one remaining part of the energy to do some external work. Okay, from the first law of thermodynamics we will get. Okay, so whatever the amount of heat we are supplying at the constant pressure, how much fraction is utilized to increase the internal energy. So here F means here fraction. Okay, na? The fraction equal to the internal energy to increase the internal energy to the total heat. Okay, na? That means we are supplying the Q heat, how much fraction of that total heat utilized to increase the internal energy, that fraction we have to find. Okay, del U by del Q. Del U, well, internal energy formula in all processes, it is this, this is only formula NCVdT, this is the same in all processes, internal energy formula is NCVdT only. Okay, so del Q, okay, heat supplied to the system, here it is at the constant pressure. At constant pressure, heat supplied equal to the NCP dT. At constant volume, NCV dT. Okay, na? That means at constant volume, the heat supplied utilized to increase only internal energy only. Okay, na? It is not doing any external work at the constant volume. But at the constant pressure, it is utilized for the two ways. One is to increase internal energy, and remaining portion is utilized for the external work. Okay, now del Q value I written NCV dT, and del Q value at constant pressure heat supplied to the system NCP dT, NN will be cancelled, dT dT will be cancelled. We are getting the fraction of heat supplied, the fraction of the heat energy supplied which is increase the internal energy of the gas is Cv by Cp we are getting. Nn cancel, dt will be cancelled, we are getting Cv by Cp. Actually we know Cp by Cv relationship is Cp by Cv equal to the gamma, but here we are getting Cv by Cp, that means 1 by gamma. So here they given ideal diatomic gas. For diatomic gas gamma value is 7 by 5. Okay, and remember the gamma formula also 1 plus 2 by F. For diatomic gas F degree of freedom is 5, from that we will get gamma equal to 7 by 5. So but here the fraction value equal to the 1 by gamma, gamma is a 7 by 5, 1 by gamma is nothing but 5 by 7. So the answer is 5 by 7. Okay, so 5 by 7 is the right answer. Okay, see the next question, 10th question. The shown PV diagram represents the thermodynamic cycle of an engine operating with an ideal monoatomic gas. This is the monoatomic gas. The amount of heat extracted from the source. Remember this point. It is extracting from the source means the heat is given to the system. Okay. In a single cycle is amount of heat extracted from the source we have to find. Okay, now to confuse us the given extracted from the source. Extracted from the source means heat given to the system. So now see this is the diagram, PV diagram they given A, B, C, D, A. Okay, now this is the cyclic process. In this A to B volume is constant. Okay, now from ideal gas equation PV equal to the nRT, volume is a constant, nR also constant, P is directly proportional to the T. So that means A to B pressure P naught to 2 P naught increase, pressure increased means temperature also increased, temperature increased means something heat it absorbed. Okay, now so something heat is given to the system from A to B. And B to C, okay, B to C pressure is constant but volume increased from V naught to the 2 V naught. So if pressure is constant, relationship between the volume and temperature is directly proportional to volume increased from V naught to 2 V naught, means so temperature increased, that's why volume increases. So volume increased means took some heat. Okay, now system absorbed some heat. So A to B, B to C, system absorbed the heat or heat is given to the system. Okay, now C to D at the constant volume. Constant volume pressure and temperature relationship is P is directly proportional to T. 2P naught to P naught. Pressure decreased. So pressure decreased means temperature decreased. Temperature decreased means heat given out, so system given the heat, so system didn't take the heat in this case. Okay, and the next one, D to A pressure is constant, then relationship between the volume and temperature is volume is directly proportional to the temperature. Volume decreased means it lost some amount of the temperature, it lost some amount of the temperature means it lost some amount of the heat. So in this case C to D and D to A, system lost the heat and it given out the heat. But in the A to B and B to C, it absorbed the heat. Okay, A to B, B to C, system absorbed the heat, and C to D, D to A, system lost the heat. But in the question, they are asking the amount of heat extracted from the source, the amount of heat given to the system. So we have to consider the process A to B, B to C only. So in these two cases, it is losing the heat. But the question they are asking how much it is given to the system. Given to the system means A to B, B to C. Okay. Now from the first law of thermodynamics, heat given to the system, heat supplied to the system equal to the, so change in the internal energy plus work done. A to B to C, this ABC process only we have to consider. So now internal energy from ABC process and work done from ABC process we have to consider. Okay. So internal energy formula for all the processes, I said NCV del T, this is the formula. So N into CV into del T means final temperature minus initial temperature plus work done. Work done is nothing but this graph is nothing but PV graph only. Work done is nothing but the area under the curve, PV graph. Okay, no? That I written. So N into, and here the given monoatomic gas. For monoatomic gas, CV value is 3 by 2 R. So CV value 3 by 2 R I written. T final minus T initial. I considering process from A to C. Okay, through B. Okay, so now final is the C, initial is the A. So final temperature at the C and initial temperature at the A. Okay, TC minus TA. plus area under the PV graph. So this is constant volume here. So area is the area equal to the zero, work done equal to the zero here, volume is constant, then work done equal to the zero. Now this BC curve consider the area under this one. Okay, now area under this one means here pressure is 2P naught and change in the volume, this one 2V naught minus V naught, V naught, V naught into 2P naught. Okay, now V naught into 2P naught, 2P naught, V naught. So area under this BC curve is the 2P naught, V naught. Okay, completed. Next, so NR I am multiplying inside, so 3 by 2 into NRTC minus NRTA I will get, plus 2P naught, V naught as it is. Now 3 by 2 into NRTC, from the ideal gas equation PV equal to the NRT na. Okay, so NRTC means at a C point, at C point P, C, V, C equal to the NRTC. Okay, now what is the PC value here? 2P naught. What is the VC value here? 2V naught. Okay, 2P naught into 2V naught equal to NRTC. 2P naught, 2V naught, 4P naught, V naught equal to the NRTC. NRTC plus me, we can write it as NRTC plus me 4P naught, V naught minus NRTA. Here also use the ideal gas equation. So now PA, VA equal to the NRTA. Okay, PA value is P naught, VA value is V naught, P naught into V naught. NRTA value is P naught into V naught plus 2P naught, V naught. So 3 by 2 into 4P naught, V naught minus P naught, V naught is 3P naught, V naught plus 2P naught, V naught. So this is nothing but how much we will get? 3 into 3, 9. 9 P naught, V naught by 2 plus 2P naught, V naught. So do the LCM. So 2 into 2, 4. 4 plus here 9 is there. 9 plus 4, 13. 13 P naught, V naught by 2 we will get. 13 P naught, V naught by 2. This is the answer. In this way, we have to solve the problem. Concentrate this type of questions. Maximum, we will get one question on the graph. Okay, na? Thank you.